Here's the Yeah Yeah Yeahs.
Interesting thing about Rockers of Swa, just as a whole, I would want to say that every time, like, we sit down to write a song, we never know what it's going to come out like. You know, we definitely don't have any sort of real allegiance to any genre of songwriting or type of song that we want to write. I think after our album came out and people noticed that there were sort of like songs like Maps and Y Control and Modern Romance, which are almost more ballady, they're expecting our next album to be like a bunch of ballads.
And time is gone. was wrong.
But the songs that we started writing, like after the ballads, were like songs like Rockers, which are really sort of like more minimal and really just sort of bratty, you know, and really sort of dirty and sexy kind of songs. So you never know with us. We're pretty unpredictable, I'd say. Started the IAS, it was at a point in New York where we weren't very interested in anything that was really happening music-wise, and we sort of wanted to rock the boat a bit. And it was right before the hype around the New York City music scene was just starting to broil up. A lot of stuff just starting to happen. Coming out of Brooklyn, a lot of really eclectic sort of bands coming up and stuff like that, and we sort of came up with that.
Thank you.
Karen met several years ago at Oberlin College in Ohio, and then she transferred to New York University to study film, and while she was in New York, she met Nick, their mutual friend, and when I finished at Oberlin, I moved to Brooklyn. Karen called me up saying, you know, she'd been writing songs with Nick, and she needed a drummer for an upcoming show, and the rest is history.
Actually, me and Nick, when we started playing music together, we started playing really sort of weepy, melancholy ballads, and actually really pretty ballads, but which surprises some people because what we do now is sort of on the opposite side of the spectrum of that.
Thank you.
persona is something that sort of appeared the very first time I hit the stage in this band. It was there sort of organically. It's like as soon as my foot sort of touched the stage in the context of the AES, there I was, Karen O. One of my main interests is having a dialogue with the audience.
We love New York City, that's where we're from, yeah!
Like, I'm very, very much involved with sort of engaging the audience. And for our band in particular, we definitely, I think more than other bands, try and sort of like create a more direct relationship with the audience. So when I'm spitting a beer or staring down like one particular person and just sort of letting loose and everything like that, I'm just trying to sort of destroy any sort of sense of self-consciousness in the audience. Audience member isn't aware that they're standing next to, like, you know, crammed in with a bunch of people around them, but are more sort of just involved in the spectacle. Of what's going on. When it really comes down to it, that's just what comes out. It's more of just like this instinctual thing.
Thank you.
With I know we're talking a lot about the rain, but it was like a really big it was a big deal. You're subject to the elements when you play at Central Park, and the rain seemed to stop right before the show started, like miraculously, which was really really good for us because me and Nick are kind of really kind of paranoid about being electrocuted. That's one of the things that haven't happened to me yet, electrocution.
Where's the rain? Fucking shit! We don't want no sun.
I guess we were really charged. I think we had a lot of adrenaline flowing because there was a little bit of fear, a little bit of paranoia, a little bit of nervousness about the rain, just the level of like emotion, level of energy and stuff. So that was sort of my experience.
You guys are hard. Car! Holy shit! You guys are so rad.
The origin of our name, Yeah Yeah Yeahs, was Nick and I, before we ever sat down to write any sort of music for the Yeah Yeahs, we sort of came up with the name, like the logo, just like
a
manifesto of sorts. And I guess like one night we were just drinking at a bar, brainstorming names for a band all night long, and then Nick overheard like a couple next to us conversationally saying, "Oh yeah yeah yeah, you know that's great, yeah 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 yeah." I think it's a New York City sort of what would you say, like
reaction to everything.
Reaction to everything. You'll hear it all the time here for some reason. It's good. It works for us because it can go either way. That's sort of more yeah yeah yeah, that's great, or yeah yeah yeah.
This next song goes to you guys. We love New York City. It's where we're from. Yeah. I've been working on pieces, streets of sex and desperation. I've been screwing on the tracks of abandoned train stations. Yeah Yeah Yeahs.
And you're watching Central Park on the Yeah Yeah Yeahs net. The song Cheated Hearts, yeah, which is a real old Yeah Yeah song that we've tried to pull out now and then, you know, over the course of, you know, maybe about 3 years or so. And now we think, you know, we've got like a good solid version of it. Karen and Nick have done really, really beautiful acoustic versions of the song. It's a ballad. It's really pretty.
Cheated by the opposite, love held on high.
Black Tongue is, I think, when me and Nick were going through more. Well, me and Nick are always sort of going through like a more dancey phase, you know. And we just wanted like a real sort of consistent dance beat, and try and do something that just got people's got people, you know, to shake their butt and stuff. So I think that's like that was the phase for Black Tongue. Yeah. Times where there's technical difficulties, and it's pretty remarkable, you know, how sort of huge of responsibility and how hard Nick is working up there. Yeah, I mean, like the amount of sound that comes out of this little man is like astonishing, and it's a wall of sound. I think like every time we go up there, every night we're, you know, improvising every single night. And it's like sort of, I think some other bands like might have the same set list like every night, or have like a routine that they go through. But with us, it's just always, we're just kind of in the moment, relying on each other and like improvising. That's sort of like what's so, I think, special about our dynamic on stage, like in performing, is just like, is just how sort of in the moment we try and be. We'll be right back. Maps for the Yeah Yeah Yeahs is the song that we definitely want everybody, like, in the universe to hear. It's definitely kind of our baby. Initially, when me and Nick wrote it, I have to say that sort of instantly, it was one of those experiences in songwriting where instantly, as soon as it was down on tape, it just took on a life of its own. It's a song that really kind of stands alone, on our album, and I think that that we get really sort of just a strong sort of reaction and sort of sense of connection when we play it.
Say.
the outfit that I was wearing, Christian Joy, who designs all my outfits, she always just comes to the show. I never see them before the night of the show or an hour before. She whips it out and she's like, this is what you're wearing today. And so we incorporated the poncho into the outfit. It was like, it was a multicolored leotard. but I think that a big part of it became the plastic poncho, which at first was fully covering me, but then became a really nice little tutu for myself because Christian's outfit actually was riding up my butt like the whole the whole performance. And so I was trying to cover my lower half, but the poncho definitely was something that wouldn't have happened without the rain. So.
I know you might not believe this, but this is really our last show of a real long time. And we just wanted you to know that we love, fuck man, we love New York City, man.
Yeah, our show in Central Park was a blast. You know, it was definitely a thrill to play with Devo. And it was our first New York show in a while, so it was great to get back in front of the New York crowd and do our thing.
Our last shows, you know, we go from here to Tokyo. You're not gonna see us for a fucking long time after that, so I'd like to spell something out for you. Devo. We'd like to spell Devo. We're gonna spell Devo for you because Devo's coming up next. All right, let's do it. Can we hear a D? D! I woke up this morning in such a bad, bad mood. And it was raining out, and I came over here, I dragged myself over here, and then I saw Devo, and they were doing their sound check, and holy shit, they're so good. What they were playing when we came.
Now it's time for a summer stage flashback. Devo!
See you. Oh yeah, I've seen the Yeah Yeah Yeahs before.
We have to say yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Well, it's the year to be hated. So glad that we made it. 'Cause all the kids in the street are whisper sounds that sweet. The stars under their feet. Well, it's the year to be hated.
Sometimes I have a hard time recollecting the actual performance, which is usually a good thing. It usually means that I was in the zone for it.
Yeah, I mean, something definitely happens for each of us. While we play that, I guess athletes call it the zone. I don't know what musicians call it, other than the zone, I guess. Yeah, it's kind of like a mixture of nervous energy and fear and excitement and
passion and violence and I don't know, all those things. I guess you could say that we were in that place then.
Yeah, it's hard to talk about the zone without, you know, going into some sort of ecstatic state, or it's really like another dimension. You know, the fourth dimension is really like the zone. Yeah, there's really no words to describe it. You're just kind of there.
Well, when Brian's in the zone, sometimes blood splattering out of his nose. In the case of Friday night, instead of blood splattering all over the place when he's in the zone, it was steam rising off of him like he was some sort of a chimney.
Yeah. Smokestack.
Which definitely, I think definitely meant that Brian was in the zone.
Yeah.
You know, you could see it, you could see it, its physical manifestation, you know.
Yeah, so. It's like a flame inside.
The first show I ever saw in Central Park was probably 7 years ago. I'm not sure. It was before I lived in New York, and I came down to meet a friend, and we went to go see Sonic Youth play there, and it was really exciting. So definitely be playing on the same stage where I first saw them was kind of a thrill.
My first show that I saw at Central Park was just, I guess, 4 or 5 years ago. It was Joan Jett, and I remember she she like the thing, one of her moves.
4th of July.
Yeah, 4th of July, Joan Jett, and one of her big moves is like to throw out picks into the audience, and I wanted one of those picks so bad, but I didn't get one, so never mind.
My first show at Central Park was seeing a busker doing Beatles covers on the John Lennon Memorial.
How was it?
It was fantastic.
Don't you know? Oh, there's no modern romance. Time is gone. Wrong. It never lasts. this is no. Oh, there is no modern romance. Oh, there is no modern romance. This is no modern romance. There is no modern romance. This is no. There is no.
Really honored to be playing Summer Stage. I think it's like a big deal. It feels like a real New York thing to do, and like, and I don't know how many people are invited to play Summer Stage, and especially alongside Devo, you know. I have friends that wanted to fly out, you know, from all over like the country just to see Yeah Yeahs and Devo play, you know. So I mean, it's definitely like a really special, you know, experience and opportunity for us.